يثبت الله الذين آمنوا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة.
The Honorable Revolt. The Honorable Revolt of Ahmed bin Nasser al-Khuza'i. Now, many of you may not know who this Imam is. He's an Imam, first and foremost. You won't know when he was born, what era he was in, what's his story, and why I'm discussing him today.
Okay, the next one I have for you is that Ahmed ibn Nasr al-Khuza'i from the Imams. He was from the Imams who rebelled against Al-Wathiq because he was an innovator. And Ahmed ibn Hanbal, Imam Ahmed, praised him by saying he sacrificed his soul for Allah's path.
So this you're saying, it shows that it's permissible to do a khuruj on an oppressive Muslim leader or an innovator. So this, first of all, we say that there's a few ways of responding to it. The first one is that it hasn't been transmitted that the death, or the reason why he was killed, this great Imam, Ahmed ibn Nasr al-Khuza'i, it was because of khuruj. And Ibn Khatib al-Baghdadi mentions in his tariq, from the tariqa of Muhammad ibn Yahya al-Suli, okay? And he mentions the story. And in that chain, Khatib al-Baghdadi was one, in the chain is Muhammad ibn Yahya al-Suli. And he never met Ahmed ibn Nasr al-Khuza'i. Because Ahmed ibn Nasr al-Khuza'i, he died the year 231 Hijriah. And al-Suli passed away, what? 336 Hijriah. So between their death is more than what? 800 years.
Yeah.
And there's no mentioning in the tarjama of Muhammad ibn Yahya al-Suli that he lived for a very long time. Rather, what is mentioned in his biography is that he narrated from Abu Dawud. This is considered from the students of al-Imam Ahmed Nasr al-Khuza'i. Okay? Because Abu Dawud is considered to be like a student of Imam al-Bukhari, right? And Bukhari is considered to be a student of who? The tabaq of Imam Ahmed, right? The third, second way of responding to this is that this goes against the ijma'u ahli sunnah. Because ahli sunnah wal jama'ah, they made ijma' that you're not allowed to go against oppressive Muslim leader. And they also mentioned tabdi' of the one who does go against oppressive Muslim leader. And from the people who transmitted a ijma' that the person is a mubtadi' who goes against an oppressive Muslim leader is none other than who? Al-Imam Ahmed ibn Hanbal. So it's very far-fetched that Ahmed will praise someone for something he transmits an ijma' for. Not only does he just transmit an ijma', but he also transmits ya'ni that that person is a mubtadi' for going against the oppressive Muslim leader. Also, that which it seems like that Ahmed ibn Nasr al-Khuza'i was actually killed for was his patience on the issue of the Quran being the speech of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and that he wasn't created. And that is why the scholars praised him for. And Imam al-Dhahabi, he mentions, he says, قال ابن الجنيد, Ibn al-Junayd said, سمعت يحيى بن معين, I heard يحيى بن معين يترحم عليه, saying, Allah, oh Allah, have rahma on Ahmed ibn Nasr al-Khuza'i. ختم الله له بالشهادة. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala ended his life based on shahada. He died upon shahada. وقال المرودي, مرودي, he said, سمعت أحمد بن حنبل saying, about Ahmed Nasr al-Khuza'i, saying, لقد جاد بنفسه, he sacrificed his life. يعني he sacrificed his life. Here, what it seems like is that because of the issue of khalq al-Quran, the people being tested, he wasn't the only person who was killed. Abu, يعني great other imams, Abu Ya'qub al-Buwayti was killed, Ibn Nuh was killed, يعني other people were murdered and killed by the leader because of this issue of the khalq al-Quran. And everyone knows the issue of khalq al-Quran was being tested on the people. It wasn't that the ulama were hiding. They were willing to be silent. But they were being tested. They were like, no, 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 come forward. What do you believe regarding this? Okay. Also, what we also have to remember is that Ahmed ibn Nasr al-Khuza'i, if he did do khuruj, he's not a proof in and within himself. Remember we said that the ijma' precedes him, the ijma' before him. After the fitna of Ibn Ash'ad, ijma' came, and that the statement of a great imam like this, and other than him, cannot be used as a proof. You can't say, Ahmed Nasr al-Khuza'i said, so because of it is a proof. Okay? And Allah knows best, subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Okay. Do you believe that the Muhammad ibn Sa'ud and Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rebelled against the Ottoman Empire?
Can I just go back to one thing that I just remembered about Ahmed ibn Nasr al-Khuza'i?
Okay.
Abu al-Abbas ibn Sa'adin, as Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi mentions in his tariq, he mentions that the fifth volume, page 177, that Abu al-Abbas ibn Sa'adin, he said, لم يصبر في المحنة إلا أربعة كل من أهل مرو. Four people were patient upon the mihna, يعني the issue of Khalq al-Quran. Ahmad ibn Hanbal, Abu Abdullah, Ahmad ibn Nasr ibn Malik al-Khuza'i, Muhammad ibn Nuh ibn Maymun al-Madrub, wa Nu'aym ibn Hamad al-Khuza'i, وقد مات في السجن مقيدا فأما أحمد بن نصر فضربت عنقه, his neck was struck, وهذه نسخة يعني this shows that the issue of the death of أحمد بن نصر الخزاعي was mainly because of the fact that he was what patient upon the issue of خلق القرآن. That's what he mentions. It doesn't mention that it was a خارج على السلطان. It doesn't mention that in the narrations. Wallahu a'lam. Sorry.